For increasing and decreasing functions, if we are given if y is equal to fx is a given function of x, then point number one, for increasing function, we find the value of dy by dx and take it as greater than 0, and for decreasing function, we find the dy by dx value as usual and take it as lesser than 0. So this is the only condition that we have to remember and apply whenever you are asked to find out the increasing and the decreasing function. For example, if we consider that y is equal to x cube plus 12x square plus 36x plus 6, and you are given already that the function is an increasing function, we have to find out the value of x which satisfies the condition of the increasing function, so that it is derivative is greater than 0 has to be assumed. So so now let us understand how we do this. Come on, I will say over here, consider y is equal to x cube plus 12x square plus 36x plus 6, and usually as we do, differentiate with respect to x. So derivative of y, as we all know, is equal to derivative of x cube is 3x square, 12 into derivative of x square. Now derivative of x square is 2x, so 12 into 2x will give me 24x. 36x, derivative of x is 1, so 36 times 1 is 36. 6 is a constant, so the derivative is 0. From all these terms, I can take out 3 common, so I get x square plus 8x plus 12. So that is my required value of dy by dx. Now we write over here, since y is an increasing function. We are writing it like this directly over here because it is given that y is an increasing function. So I will get over here, therefore, the derivative is greater than 0, and therefore I can say 3 into x square plus 8x plus 12 is greater than 0. This 3 gets divided on the opposite side, so 0 upon 3 will become 0, and this bracket element will be factorized. So the simple factors that we will get over here, x square plus 6x plus 2x plus 12 to be greater than 0. And therefore, x into x plus 6 plus 2 into x plus 6 is greater than 0. So here I can say that x plus 6 into x plus 2 should be greater than 0. Now listen very carefully, guys. In case if you are writing, then just stop writing and understand very carefully. You are having over here the product of two factors, x plus 6 and x plus 2, and we require that the product of these numbers should be greater than 0. If I want the product to be greater than 0, I require that it is a positive product. And if I want a positive product, the two conditions that I know, positive into positive is equal to positive, negative into negative is also positive. So this, how should we represent this with the help of symbols? Let us understand this very carefully. I will get over here. Therefore, x plus 6 is greater than 0 and x plus 2 is greater than 0 satisfies the first positive and positive. Or x plus 6 is lesser than 0 and x plus 2 is also lesser than 0 satisfies the second condition. So when I know that the product x plus 2 and x plus 6 is greater than 0, so in that case I consider both the factors to be greater than 0 in the first case and both the factors to be lesser than 0 in the second case. After that, just take the numbers on the opposite side. So I will get x is greater than negative 6 and x is greater than negative 2, or x is lesser than negative 6 and x is lesser than negative 2. I am just transferring the numbers on opposite sides in both the cases, nothing else. So after this, what we do is we have to identify which of these different cases will satisfy our condition that the derivative is greater than 0. So for that, we draw a small number line in our rough work and we consider the required numbers which are present over here. What are the numbers? You are having minus 6 and minus 2. Now the next step is again very important. Listen, I require x to be greater than minus 6. If I want numbers greater than minus 6, it means that it has to be the right side values of the number x greater than minus 6. As well as when I want x is greater than negative 2, again I want the right side values of this. So it means this part. So I can observe the overlapping region is this. Why we are considering overlapping? The simple reason is that when x is greater than minus 2, definitely it has to be greater than minus 6 also. That's why we consider the overlapping region, and out of this both we are selecting this. The same logic will be applied in the second case. X is lesser than negative 6, so let us see over here. Lesser than means the left region, so it is this part. X lesser than negative 2, so once again left region of negative 2. Once again guys, overlapping region comes at x is lesser than negative 6, because any number lesser than negative 6 by default has to be lesser than negative 2 also. Therefore I consider this. So our solution will be like this. Therefore solution, x is greater than negative 2 or x is lesser than negative 6. So now listen very carefully guys. When I have over here x to be greater than negative 2, it means that it can go till positive infinity. So this can be represented like this, minus 2 comma infinite. So iska matlab aisa hota hai that minus 2 will be the smallest value and infinity over here will be the greatest value. So minus 2 comma infinity. The same thing is applicable in the second case also. If I know that x is lesser than negative 6, it can go up till negative infinity anywhere from minus 6. Therefore this can be written as negative infinite comma negative 6. Why do we write it like this? So simple reason that you need to remember, the first number is smaller number and the second number is the greater number. Same way here, it is negative infinity has to be a smaller value and negative 6 will be the greater value over here, because as we proceed on the number line, the left values are always lesser than the values which are on the right. Now negative infinity is to the left of negative 6, therefore I am considering that negative infinity is smaller than negative 6.
So let's see an example for the decreasing function. You are given the question that y is equal to 2x cube minus 9x square plus 12x plus 5 is decreasing, and you need to find the value of x. So starting step will be the same. We will say consider y is equal to 2x cube minus 9x square plus 12x plus 5, and differentiate this with respect to x. The derivative of y is dy by dx. So this is 2 into 3x square, giving you 6x square, minus 9 into 2x, 18x, plus 12 into 1 is 12. Derivative of 5 is 0, so we leave that. Just take out that 6 common over here. So x square minus 3x plus 2. Now in the question, he has very clearly told that the function is decreasing. So we will say over here, since y is a decreasing function, I will get over there. Therefore, as per our condition, we will say that decreasing function has to be derivative lesser than 0. Take that 6 into x square minus 3x plus 2. Divide this 6 on the opposite side like we did in the above case and factorize the bracket. I get x square minus 2x minus x plus 2 lesser than 0. Therefore, x into x minus 2 minus 1 into x minus 2. I will get x minus 2 into bracket x minus 1 is lesser than 0. So this implies that the product of two numbers required is negative. So if I require negative product, again I have two conditions. First factor positive multiplied by the second factor negative, then the answer has to be negative. Otherwise, first factor negative multiplied by the second positive factor, still the answer will be negative. How did I understand it is negative? Because we are having the symbol of lesser than zero, and obviously all the numbers lesser than zero have to be negative. Therefore, I consider the negative product over here. So how should I represent these both steps with the notation? So let us understand that, guys. If you are writing, don't write, listen, and then copy down later on. This will become x minus 2. I want positive greater than 0. I want second factor negative. So and x minus 1 lesser than. Otherwise, first negative, second positive. Less than 0 and x minus 1 greater than 0. Then like we did in the previous sum, take the numbers and the variables on the opposite sides. Matlab this 2 and minus 1 will go on the right or left. So x greater than 2 and x lesser than 1. Otherwise, x lesser than 2 and x is greater than 1. Now just listen very carefully, guys. You are having two numbers, 1 and 2. So in my rough work on my number line, I will just take two simple numbers, 1 and 2. Now just observe how we select the required common region. I require in the first case x is greater than 2. It means that it will go to the right side of 2. I require x to be lesser than 1 in the first case, so it will go to the left side of 1. Oh, so now over here I observe the first is going to the right, the second is going to the left. So it means that there is no common region left over here. If there is no common region, so it does not mean that your answer or working is wrong. Apne paas ek aur condition available hai. We are having one more condition left. So I will take the second condition. See, x is lesser than 2, matlab wo 2 se left mein ja raha hai. X is greater than 1, so it will go to the right of 1. So I observe this part is an overlapping part. It means that value of x will be something between 1 and 2. Therefore, my solution will be like this. 1 lesser than x lesser than 2. So it indicates that x is between 1 and 2. So I can say over here that is, it is 1, 2 is the required solution set.